So very aware that Ramadan is drawing to a close, and last night was the Lailat al-Qadr, this night of power, the night when prayers made on that night are more powerful than any other night of the year. And this deep connection with the Prophet Muhammad, As-salamu alayhim, and he had the habit of being on retreat for a month every year. He would go to a cave in the desert in the mountains and be on retreat by himself. And it was during one of those retreat nights that the angel Jibril, angel Gabriel, came to him and started to recite or to give him this message of the Quran. So that's our focus for today, feeling into this. I'm very into caves at the moment, this dark, safe space in the body of the Mother Earth, where we can retreat and go into the darkness and the silence to receive messages, to receive blessings, and also to offer up our prayers. So let's begin to explore that fertile darkness with our breath as we say our invocation together.
Towards the One, the perfection of love, harmony and beauty, the only being, united with all the illuminated souls who form the embodiment of the Master, the message, the mystery, the miracle, the Mother, the Spirit of Guidance. And just taking a few breaths to remember our own illuminated nature. We are amongst these illuminated souls embodying. The light of the soul inhabiting the cave of the body. So these may have been the words that the angel Gabriel spoke. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of the only being. In the name of love. So Pir Shabda advises us to every day to make a practice with one of the names of strength, because everybody needs strength. We need strength to survive in these times. So calling on that strength and power and remembering the night of power, Lailat al-Qadr.
So we're going to use three beautiful names. The first, Muqtadir.
Muqtadir.
So this is the one who manifests our soul's purpose. Gives us the strength to do that. Yaqadr.
Yaqadr.
This is where the will of the one being is, and the power of that will is manifest through us. We see the power of Yaqadr working in the universe. Yamateen.
Ya matin.
This is the quality of steadiness, of rhythm, and of strength that comes from that rhythm, that steadiness. Let me say, Hu Allah.
Hu Allah.
So, Muqtadir.
Muqtadir.
Ya Qadr.
Ya Qadr.
Ya Mateen.
Ya Mateen.
Hu Allah.
Hu Allah.
It's a good one to get us stepping on the path with strength, purpose, and power. Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen. Hu Allah, Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen. Four times.
Hu Allah, Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen. Hu Allah, Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen.
Listen, Allah. So imagine you're walking. Imagine we're walking to the right. So,
Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen. Hu Allah, Muqtadir ya Qadr ya Mateen. Hu Allah.
So on Hu Allah, on Mateen we stop. So we bring the left foot in, just a step. Touch next to the right, like making a little stamp. I like to think a stamp of power, of certainty, of resolve.
Mateen is steadiness, isn't it, as well? So it's like taking our, finding our balance and steadiness.
And then we bow, Hu Allah. And then on Allah, 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 Hu Allah, etc., we're going to be walking in and walking out twice. And when we're walking, we're swinging our heart to the right and to the left, as if we've got, I like to imagine, a great big searchlight beaming out from our heart into the world, swinging from side to side, taking it all in. So it's like, Allah, 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 hu Allah, back.
Allah, Allah, Allah,
forwards.
Allah, 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 Allah.
Can I just say something?
Yeah.
So, I just wanted to share that I don't feel comfortable with that searchlight image, so I just wanted to say that because it might not work for everybody. So
yeah.
it's great if it does work for you, but what I find I'm doing is kind of settling into my heart and waking it up, feeling it energized, but feeling it here in my body. The searchlight takes me kind of there. So it's not
so really taking your attention into your
but
heart.
That's what it's doing for me, is like, you know, and I love this movement that just really energizes it and wakes it up. And right here. So, you know, one thing or another might work for you. So you allow yourself your own experience.
Yeah, if it doesn't work, don't do it. If it works, keep doing it. So walking to the right.
Allah, 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 Allah.
as we just stop and breathe, perhaps we could imagine this rhythm continuing inside us, giving us strength and power to move forwards, keeping on. On the path. Amen.
Amen.
It does feel significant that we're told that Muhammad had this practice already of going on retreat for a month every year. As you said this morning, you know, he was already a spiritual man. There's no question that that kind of preparation, that kind of connection with the almighty power, the Qadr of the universe is... The more we open to that, the more we embody it, the more gifts will come through that. It's not possible for all of us to go on retreat for a month every year. It doesn't have to look like that. But what it can look like is this stability and steadiness and sense of not only of the power, the Qadr, that is there, but also of how that power comes through us, the Muqaddar, the one who brings the power through us. Again, an invitation to remember that it's not something separate from us, it's not something far away, it's there, it's accessible to us, but we have to remember. Remember to open to it, remember to be aware of it, remember to invite it. What are we going to do next?
Just tuning in. I don't know, really.
I think Yasalam.
Yeah.
Because these are more qualities that help us.
Did I do it in... C minor in the end.
I think so.
Yeah. So some more qualities, as Jilani just said, to help us on our journey in life. Ya Salam.
Ya Salam.
Peace. Ya Hadi.
Ya Hadi.
Divine guidance, the guide. Sometimes this is can be seen as the most general word in Arabic for guidance, referring to any and all forms of guidance that come to us, that come through us. And it can also refer to the specific guidance that is given for the whole of humanity, particularly referring to guidance such as that received by Muhammad, which became the Quran, but other forms of guidance that have been put in holy books of different kinds. So, Ya Salam, Ya Hadi.
Ya Salam, Ya Hadi.
And then Allah.
Allah.
Unity, oneness, that which cannot be named. cannot be truly expressed through words. Ya Salam, Ya Hadi. Again,
Ya Salam, Ya Hadi.
Listen, Ya Salam, Ya Hadi. We repeat that.
Ya Salam, Ya Hadi.
Listen. Allah, 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 Allah. Let's go from the Allahs.
Allah, 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 Allah.
Ya Hadi. Again.
Ya Salam.
Ya Hadi. Ya Salam.
Ya Salam. Ya Hadi. Ya Salam.
Something about this dance, it goes through a kind of an energetic cycle of building up through peace and opening to guidance, and then coming down again to a state of quietness and receptiveness, ready for the next flow of guidance.
It also reminds me of that cave. It's got that warm darkness about it, the way it starts and
yes.
finishes, and that
yes.
holding darkness.
So, for the first bit of Ya Salam, Ya Hadi, we're raising our arms, opening our palms to the heavens, and then we're going to be touching our head, our lips, and our heart. And the originator of this dance sometimes says thoughts, words, deeds. We don't actually say that, but we can think that to ourselves. So this is peace in our thoughts, words, deeds. So Ya Salam,
Ya.
After we've touched our hearts, we're gradually opening our arms wide, leaning back a little, opening our chest, opening to guidance. And then we do that again.
Yes.
encourage you to be just step with the beat while we're doing this.
Can you just show us again how it fits with the stepping? Because
yeah.
I'm not getting that.
So it's Ya Salam, Ya Hadi, Ya Salam. Thoughts, words, deeds, Ya Hadi.
Because that feels quite busy, that stepping. Is that how it goes? Or
well,
yeah,
when
yeah.
we're walking a circle, this is how. Ya Salam.
Yeah, fine. I'm just going to question you. Just thought.
Yeah.
I just was feeling busy.
Otherwise, it'd be. Ya Salam. I don't know. Anyway.
Sorry.
We're stepping anyway.
We're stepping. That's
you
the thing.
Step
do what works for you.
Whatever speed works for you, but. In time with the music helps. And then for the second time, we're actually going to be doing this, touching our head, lips and heart at twice the speed. So this time it's Ya Salam. So it's thoughts, words, deeds. So it's Ya Salam. Oh, sorry, wrong hand. Right hand on heart. Left hand. Ya Salam. And then on Ya Hadi, we're pointing our finger to the heavens, connecting with that guidance, being the guidance, perhaps even manifesting it ourselves.
Reminds me of that picture. Is it Leonardo? No, is it Michelangelo?
Michelangelo,
with the
yes.
Yeah.
Ya Salam. So one, two, three. Thoughts, words, deeds. Ya Salam, Ya Hadi, Ya Salam, Ya Hadi. And then the next bit, pretty simple, we're just walking in and out. And then on the slow Allahs at the end, we'll just be swaying. So let's do that. Allah, Allah, Allah. Words, deeds, Feel like we're back in the cave.
So I want to lead a dance which we often have danced at midwinter. It's been really with me over the last few days. The words Laila Umma. So this Laila is this word for the night. It's also often used as a name, woman's name. And Umma, the great mother. So the mother night, the darkness is this holding, supporting mother energy, the darkness of the womb, the darkness of the cave. Laila Umma.
Laila Umma.
And we also say Ya Quduz.
Ya Quduz.
So the most holy, sacred. And it always has a layer of meaning in Quduz, which is about the space, making the space, the sacred space, the temple space, making the space in the heart, making the space in the cave, this sacred space, entering into that most holy of holies, that sacred space. And also just who. It's like the breath of unity. And one thing that's essential if we're going to be able to receive guidance, even prophecy, we're going to make the connections which allow our prayers to be heard and answered. We need not only the qualities of strength that we started with, and the quality of peace is also essential, this peace, this sacred space. Without carving out that sacred, peaceful space for ourselves, we can't hear. So Ya Quduz.
Ya Quduz.
We set that up first of all. Just play me the chord. Ya Quduz, Ya Quduz. which ultimately works as a round. So if you, once you pick it up, you can take one of the voices of the round and harmonize with us. It goes, Laila Uma. Again with Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus. So it's got quite a free flowing form. To some extent, you can change when you feel ready to. And Ya Kudus, we've got these arms folded over the heart, so we're just entering into this sacred internal space, entering into the cave, entering into the retreat. And then when, as we come to the Laila Uma, we can briefly have our arms in this mothering holding position, and then we take up this wonderful nurturing movement of the hands at the heart, making this figure of eight. Infinity movement, so the left hand facing up, the right hand facing down, and then they turn over as we trace this sign of infinity. This is again clearing the space, nurturing the space, allowing the nurturing of Mother Night, Mother Darkness. You can think of all of our relationship with darkness. Sometimes darkness feels like a safe retreat, but sometimes it feels frightening, in the darkness of depression or the darkness of being alone in the night. But this is an opportunity to really feel into that holding, mothering quality of the dark, of the night. Being held in this cave, in the belly of the mother, this womb space. Nurturing this sacred space. I think we'll stand up. So we start to the left, this receptive moon half of our bodies, this moving to the left first of all. Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus, Ya Kudus. Yeah.
And as we rest in this peaceful holding darkness, the sacred cave of the Mother, the night of the Mother, Mother Night, Mother Darkness holding us, maybe there's a ray of light which begins to penetrate. Nabi Mustafa, Rasul, Prophet, Chosen One, Messenger. Nabi Mustafa, Rasul. Allah Nuri Muhammad. This light of Muhammad, this is like the, what's sometimes called the Christ light, this light of Muhammad which shines, which we can feel shining through all of the cosmos, shining through each one of us, this ray of light penetrating the darkness of the cave, the Nuri Muhammad.
Mustafa Rasul.
comfortable and seated, and just taking a few breaths to allow this Nuri Muhammad to travel down this column of light, this ray of light penetrating the sacred space of the cave. You are chosen. You are prophet. You are messenger. You are Allah, Nuri Muhammad. So these were not the first words that the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, received, but they were received by him in this prophetic manner of guidance.
Yeah.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmani Rahim. Ar-Rahmani Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi.
Come.
al-mustaqim.
Ihdina sirat 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 al-mustaqim.
Oh,
in the presence of unity, the womb of love, the sun and moon of love. All praise, all blessings return to the only being, the creator and sustainer of all the worlds, whose nature is love. This presence, this sacred unity was there before the beginning of time and will be there after the end of time, before the beginning of this physical reality and after the end of this physical reality. You alone do we adore, and to you alone do we turn for guidance. Guide us on the straight path, on the path that says, stand up, get going, do it. This is not the path of anger or despair, which only arises when we wander too far from the wellspring of love. Let's recite one more time. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladina anamta alayhim. Khairil maktubi alayhim. Walladalin. Amen. I'd like to close with the song that the women of Medina sang to welcome the Prophet back to the city. Stepping back on the left foot 3 steps and then stepping in And then finally turning on Muhammad Rasulullah. Amin, amin, as-salatu as-salamu alayka, ya Nabi Allah, ya Rasulallah.
Amin.
Amin.